Okay, thank you for the nice, kind introduction. Also, yeah, thank you for giving me this opportunity to share the research in my group. So, the topic is around nanoenergy and nano-optoelectronics. I will focus more on structure, reactivity, and stability. So, next, I want to share, I want to introduce my research group at Australian National University. So our research group, we focus on several different subjects, research field, including the solar field, battery, wearables, and optoelectronics, electronics. So my research group is material science and with some applications. Okay, for this talk, just as I mentioned, I will give some is a brief introduction, and also I will share one work in details. First, I want to brief some research activity in my group. My group is material science and application, right? So first, we do some defects engineering to study the structure and how structure affect reactivity, how structure will affect the stability. The first work, published several years ago. It is about magnesium oxide. We try to introduce the oxygen vacancy and also generate some surface states. Very interesting, we found that the surface states, we have many states in the surface, but in the end, all the states we are working as the electron transport path. The electron will transfer from different states and accumulate at the bottom, then emit out the blue light. So we call the blue magnesium oxide. So this is very important to stabilize magnesium oxide because the electron only stay at the bottom of these states. So the electron will go to the connection band at MgO, so MgO will not be reduced. So this research, we found that this special structure will can receive very stable activity. So based on this one, we further study that because we know magnesium oxide has the vacancy, has surface states. Can we introduce some plasmonic? We wanted to study cytoplasmonic, any coupling effect please between plasmonic and the surface states and the oxygen vacancy. We found it very interesting. The performance increase, certainly increase in the water splitting, and also the stability quite is very excellent. This is because gold is always stable. And also, as just now mentioned, the MgO is also stable because electron will not go to connection band. So at the end, we found that this gold, blue MgO is quite excellent in the water splitting reactions. So again, still, we are working with structure to tune the structure for the different materials. This is a bismuth manganate. So normally, people, we are looking at how to improve efficiency by doping the other elements or something. So here, we found that we do not by doping, we just try to use special argon plasma treatment to introduce the surface states. The surface states mainly relate to the oxygen vacancy. We found that the oxygen vacancy will not change. The BVO is good, is the same as to harvest light, right? But the second step, maybe after you harvest light, you receive photons. Photons will change electron hole pairs. Then how about electron hole pairs will be split to the excitons will be dissociated into the electron holes? Now, how the electrons will transport to the surface, because this is important to the surface activity, right? So we found that the oxygen vacancy is good at to separate electron hole pairs and also is very good to the increase the reactivity, but they do not change photon activity. We have three roles in the one catalyst is photon activity, one is electron hole transport, and one reactivity. For this oxygen vacancy, we improve both electron hole separation transport and reactivity. We can keep the photon activity. This work published this year. So also we study the molecule chemistry. So 8 years ago, we tried to use, play the molecule chemistry, use a template to synthesize 2D materials across single layer based 2D material. We found that this 2D material is very good for the leaving exfoliation. So that's we apply this one for the battery study. They were interested in quite stable, good performance. Then after that, 2 years ago, we also tried to develop new structure, a new phase, 1T prime phase, a tungsten sulfide. We found that such structure is plays huge effect onto the reactivity and the stability of the hydrogen evolution reaction. Yeah, this is the four phase structure we played. Certainly, we are bringing the positive effect to the reactivity and the stability. Okay, for this work, we pay attention to the black phosphorus. This material is quite unstable in the air because water plus oxygen easily erode. This is the kind of materials. So we try to stabilize this is a black phosphorus by grow one model layer on top of the surface. This model layer is good to prevent water molecules entering, but this the model layer still allow oxygen. So that means oxygen will selectively oxidize the surface layer. The surface layer will be protected by the organic layer because the water will not come in. Then this material will be protected. This is for we apply the photo detector, optoelectronics device, and also found that stability after production is a bit quite good. Okay, today I want to share one work in details, more details. So-called, I use a methanol to store hydrogen fuel. I want to share how to extract hydrogen fuel from a methanol. So this outline, we introduce the methanol stream reforming scalable synthesis and how the hydrogen fuel generate. So just a little bit of background information. So normally methanol stream reforming is the industrial way for hydrogen fuel, right? So you can say this main reaction from there, but we have several concerns. The first one is pressure. This pressure quite high, and also temperature is not room temperature. And then the other concern is global warming because carbon dioxide emission. Then we ask ourselves, can we change the reaction pathway? So do we have any other way to receive hydrogen fuel from methanol without carbon dioxide emission? Yeah, this answer is here. So we try to design this reaction. And also we're trying to use the room temperature. We're trying to use without pressure. So that's a bit challenging at this time. So why this reaction? Because this reaction is, we can see, is a closed carbon loop, because even formaldehyde go back to methanol, or formaldehyde can go to carbon dioxide can reduce to methanol again. So we can see this is, the potential is a closed loop for carbon. That's important, so that let's know that zero emission to the air, let's know carbon dioxide emission. So the second one is the methanol boiling point is over 64 degree, and also liquid at room temperature, less important for transport, right? You can transport methanol instead of hydrogen, then apply catalyst to take out hydrogen for methanol when you want to use hydrogen. So formaldehyde is a product because formaldehyde is easily to liquefy at a normal and medium moderate pressure. And the formaldehyde is a good product. It can be soluble in water. Several points to support the reaction is very promising. Now I want to share the one, we have one more previous work to study this reaction. We use magnesium oxide. Yeah, this work passed several years ago. We found that the stability quite good, it's very good. And even the performance, we compare our work with some commercial study or the commercial materials, for some commercial NGO and commercial silicon oxide and a commercial titanium oxide P25. All the materials was so-called is not narrow band gap, is wide band gap materials. So especially look at this figure, we found that if they extend reaction time, so this new materials advantage benefit show up, you can see it's still stable. All others, like even commercial P25 titanium oxide, the performance will degrade, we are saturated. However, this performance is still stable. Yeah, so that means this magnesium oxide vacancy is very good promising strategy to improve performance and also improve stability. So certainly, as I shared, this reaction, we don't want carbon dioxide emission. We don't want carbon monoxide emission. So you can see we don't have a carbon monoxide, we don't have carbon dioxide. This is a control sample, this is standard control. We don't have the two peak, that means this is carbon, there's no carbon emission. However, that's not a problem for the reaction. The problem is because we found that this we rely on UV light. the visible light doesn't work. So then the next question we ask is, can we use the visible light? Because the solar, most of the solar is the visible light, right? And the performance is 320. It's not so good. So then based on this, we want to develop a new project to increase the performance further. So before I share the next work, I want to summarize the hydrogen from methanol. So up to now, so we can see, if we look at the industrial MSR methanol stream reforming, we found it is not at mass pressure. So it is not room temperature. It is not carbon dioxide free emission. It has carbon dioxide free. So it's all true, it's not, it's concern, other concerns to us. They don't use solar, right? So this is scalable because the industrial sector is scalable. So last work just now I shared, and magnesium oxide, it is AP, atmosphere pressure, it is room temperature, it's carbon dioxide free, all good, right? However, it is not solar, right? It is not scalable now, but it's potential, okay? So here, I want to change this cross, or I want to change this one to the positive one, negative one to positive one, because now we have to use a UV. Then if we use the solar, that's perfect, right? So that's where this our work. Our idea comes from there because we know one layer MS2 has a very huge, very excellent light absorption. It is compared with the traditional gallium arsenide. It is 10 times compared with 1 nanometer gallium arsenide. And if 50 times of 1 nanometer second silicon. So that's why we want to try to synthesize one layer molybdenum disulfide. So yeah, this is our synthesis strategy. If you are interested, you can look at our paper published last year, Advanced Materials. So yeah, all the synthesis strategy we described in our paper. In brief, so we played the special surfactant. The surfactant will control a special temperature and pressure. We will control the single layer formation. We will prevent two layer, three layer. So after single layer formed, and the surfactant stick on the surface. So for this kind of the surfactant is good to prevent stacking or aggregation. So that's why modulator is quite stable. There's no aggregation issue because of surfactants. AFM, our thickness is around 0.6 nanometer, and this is the absorption. And also do the XRD. And XPS and the element mapping, all this to demonstrate it is a single layer, two edge. This is the kind of phase, molybdenum disulfide. Two edge is good because the same kind of absorb light. So MS2 has several different phases, two edge, 1T, 1T prime. But here it's good news, it's two edge phase. So the question is, what is the reaction pathway? So the absorption certainly is the first one always, right? So you can see. Now, this is our single layer. Then absorption of methanol around the edge, right? Because the surfactant we are staying in plane. The edge around the methanol. So what's the next step? Next step is ceasing, cutting the OH bonds or cutting the CH bonds. So after calculation, so I will share with you what direction is the true path. So first cutting from OH or first cutting from CH. Then after that, after cutting OH, then we cut in CH, or after cutting CH, then cutting OH. So in that case, based on our calculation, we will show more. So we found that the first cutting is from OH, the second cutting is CH. We have three CH available. You can cut any more because all this is asymmetric. Then after OH cutting, the one proton released, and then after CH cutting, the second proton released, two protons go together and form the hydrogen. Okay, and then left the formaldehyde formed. So in that case, the path is P1, P2, P4, P6. So it's not P1, P3, P5, P6, because the first cutting is OH, cutting OH, okay? It's not CH. So that's why we go to 2, 4, 6. It's not 3, 5, 6. The first step was the same. Yeah, this is based on the detailed calculation. We found that the MS2 has different edge. The MO edge, blank sulfur, there's no sulfur, only MO, or MO monomer, so or MO monomer I dimer, and also sulfur monodimer, and a sulfur edge monomer. All the case, we considered, we found that our calculation based on free energy, we found that this reaction pathway is preferred. And also this direction support P1, P2, P4, P6 paths. So in terms of performance, yeah, certainly people will argue because Selectern has hydrogen, right? Maybe Selectern can provide hydrogen for hydrogen, or provide hydrogen source for hydrogen fuel. We did this control experiments. The Selectern has no performance at all. It's very low value, it's negligible. So you can see, so this is the result tells us the performance come from, not come, the hydrogen not come from Selectern. The hydrogen come from methanol after the photocatalyst reactions, photoredox activity, okay? Then we also check the stability because of this talk is about structure, reactivity and stability, right? So we found that our performance, the first cycle found performance, we are saturated. Then found a reason. Normally has two reasons, two factors will affect the saturation. The first maybe is catalyst saturated, catalyst not active. The second one is reaction partial pressure generation of hydrogen fuel, then it will block the reaction continue. So we open this reactor because the reactor is sealed. We open this reactor and we set up the reaction again. We found that the performance is come back again, then gradually saturate. Then we do the third one, then again, come back again, gradually saturate, right? So this is a very interesting phenomenon because it's the tree reversible behavior tell us the performance saturation is not because of this catalyst degradation, or it's because of the partial pressure generation of hydrogen will push back the forward reaction. So that means the catalyst is quite stable. So this reaction also adapt to another two D materials, tungsten, sulfide, rhenium, the sulfide, okay? So conclusion for this work, we try to develop scalable synthesis of single layer TMD for solar hydrogen fuel production from liquid carrier methanol. Yeah. Also at that time, we received a new record in methanol to hydrogen efficiency. And also this sustainable photoredox reaction because it is just an atmosphere pressure, room temperature, and there's no carbon monoxide, there's no carbon dioxide emission. And also it is solar harvestable, and also refreshable, reversible, or in other words, it is very stable, okay? So before I end my talk, I want to share my several review article here because it's quite related to some different research field. The first one is 2D material based on main group elements compound we synthesize, or we summarize because there's a review article invited by from different journal. In this advanced functional materials, we summarized the phase of two-dimensional summarized synthesis, and also some different characterization and with different application. Yeah, and all the for the 2D materials, if some research group is working with 2D materials phase application, yeah, this review article is very useful. And this one is a structural phase catalytic redox reactions with this for energy environmental application, and also another invite review article. And also, if somebody is interested in the energy and the environmental new technology development, you can read this paper. We summarized many different applications and reactions. And also, we combine all reactions related to the phase. Yeah, this is a very new research direction recently. This one, is invited by Chemistry Society Review Journal. Yeah, we try to summarize a lot of different surface strategies, how the strategy will be applied for catalytic carbon dioxide reduction. We summarize 2D materials, we summarize nanoclusters, and we summarize single atoms. Yeah, I think if people relate to the carbon dioxide reduction, it including photochemical, electrochemical, and for electrochemical carbon dioxide reduction, then we can maybe can find some useful surface strategy for carbon dioxide reduction reactions. Okay, thank you very much for your attention to my talk. Thank you.